Hello everyone. Today I am going to explain lecture number 10, part 1, the concept of reflection and ground reflection model, that is two-ray model. In previous lecture, we have defined the concept about the large-scale fading, the space propagation model, and three basic mechanism of a propagation mechanism, that is reflection, diffraction and scattering. In this lecture, we define how to very important in mobile propagation. We'll study statistically these three mechanism to help to define a deterministic model to analyze the when wave is traveling to free space propagation. There is a three mechanisms that wave will be happen: reflection, scattering and diffraction, and how these waves are reached to the mobile devices and how to communication will be take place. So let us begin with the first. We define the three basic mechanism which will be see in previous lecture, that is reflection, diffraction and scattering. Reflection is nothing but the occurrence a wave is propagating electromagnetic wave impinges upon an object which is have very large dimension when compared with the wavelength. For example, the wave is reflected from building, wall or surface of the earth. That is called as a reflection. Then diffraction occurs when the radio path between the transmitter and receiver is obstructed by the surface that has sharp edges. That is called as a diffraction. We also seen define the scattering. Scattering occurs when the medium through which the wave is traveled consists of an object with the dimension that are very small as compared to the wavelength, that is called as a scattering. So mostly we have the diffraction is very helpful to study the properties of electromagnetic wave when traveling in a free space. Basically we are dealing with the today's lecture, which is a reflection. What is in the reflection? What are the different models for the when it is polarized with dielectric material, when it is reflected dielectrical material, or when it is reflected from a perfect conductor, or some new terms which is related to the Fresnel reflection coefficient, all these things. So first we define what is the reflection once again. So when a radio wave is propagating in one medium and impinges upon to another medium having different electrical properties, they have partially reflected, partially transmitted. So that is called as a reflection. So Fresnel reflection coefficient, which is related to this reflection, which gives the relationship between electrical field intensity to the reflected and transmitted waves to the incident wave in a medium of the origin. Similarly, the reflection coefficient is a function of material properties depending upon the wave polarization, angle of incidence and frequency of the propagating wave. So this is about the reflection. Now I am going to explain the reflection of a dielectric material. So here the figure 1 is consist of electrical field in which in the plane of incidence. So it is present in the plane. There are the two components, orthogonal components, a vertical and second one is a horizontal. So this is an electromagnetic wave and this is a surface. This is a, we can consider as a reflecting surface with a sharp edges. So it is a, we can consider as a earth surface. So we can seen by hatching lines. And second one case, this second one figure, which consists electrical field normal to the plane of incidence. So this is perpendicular to the display and this is parallel to the display. So we can define I stand for the incidence, R for the reflector and E for, T for the transmitted. So the reflection from the this wave in the form of electrical field, that times for a perfect conductor, E field is equal to, means there is a no transmission when electrical current conductor is perfect. So that time we can define theta is equal to theta means incident angle is equal to reflected angle. So incident of electromagnetic energy is equal to the electromagnetic of reflected energy. So this is for the in the plane component. Similarly, when electrical field normal to the plane, that is the second condition. So that time this is for the reflection for the perfect conductor. So we can write down these equations are for the theta is equal to theta, that is when these are the components in a perfect conductor. So incident angle of is equal to reflected angle. So incident electromagnetic energy is equal to reflected electromagnetic energy. So that is for the when normal to the plane. So electric field is normal to the plane. So this is perpendicular and this is in a plane. So we can give the Fresnel reflection coefficient in two terms, that is when is a polarization in two orthogonal components, parallel and second one is perpendicular. So reflected energy is equal to incident energy. So eta sin theta minus n eta sin theta I, where eta is a intrinsic impedance, okay, and the second perpendicular orthogonal component, this is a Fresnel reflection coefficient, we can say that. So this ratio is given by for the perpendicular coefficient er upon is equal to ei. So intrinsic impedance into sin theta I minus intrinsic impedance 1 sin theta t, where theta t is the transmitted angle, and divided by n intrinsic impedance into sin theta I plus intrinsic impedance into sin theta t. So where intrinsic impedance is nothing but the, we can say that it is a permittivity of an material or medium divided by the permittivity divided by permeability. So that is called, and this is called as a, now in the form of velocity. So velocity of electromagnetic wave, that is waves, is given by 1 upon, that is permittivity into its permeability. So this is a ratio. So intrinsic impedance, so this intrinsic impedance is for a different dielectric material, it will be different, and it is an example of our surface is a dielectric material, which is sum of energy will be reflected, sum of energy will be refracted in the form of. So how the energy will be reached, electromagnetic energy will be reached to the mobile station, that can be calculated by this model. So now the boundary condition when the surface of incidence by using Snell law, so that will be given by this equation in the form of velocity. So mu 1 into from this figure we can calculate. So mu 1 into e 1 sin 90 minus theta I is equal to mu 2 into e 2, that is permittivity, sin 90 minus theta t. So using boundary condition we can write by using Maxwell equation, incidence of angle is equal to reflected angle. So reflected energy is equal to reflection coefficient, that is incident energy. So we can give the transmitted energy, that is in the form of this. So transmitted energy is equal to 1 plus Fresnel coefficient or reflection coefficient, that is equal to your incident energy of an electromagnetic wave. So it is a your electromagnetic wave in transmitted, Ei is the your electromagnetic energy of an incident wave. So first medium is free space, that time we can say that then permeability of first medium is equal to permeability of second medium is equal to, then reflection coefficient for vertical and horizontal polarization we can write down in this format. So permittivity of reflected sin theta I plus under root ER minus cos square theta I. Permittivity of reflectance divided by sin theta I plus permittivity of reflected minus cos square theta. This is for the parallel component. This is the reflection coefficient. Similarly, we can write down for the in a form of perpendicular. Okay, so we can write down, so sin theta minus permittivity of the reflected minus cos square theta I divided by sin theta plus under root permittivity of the reflected minus cos square theta I, where theta I is nothing but the incident angle and theta t is your reflected angle. So we can give the reflection coefficient in terms of vertical and horizontal polarization. So if the medium is free space, then permittivity is equal to absolute permittivity of medium is 2 is dielectrical, then for horizontal the reflection coefficient is minus 1 and vertical that is minus 1 regardless if ER is not present. When theta is equal to 0, then the ground model perfect reflector, the reflection coefficient is unity of magnitude when the incident waves grazes the earth regardless the polarization of the ground dielectric fields. Now we define the Brewster angle. So what is the Brewster angle? So Brewster angle, the angle at which no reflection is occur of a, in the medium its origin, so that is called as a your Brewster angle. So Brewster angle, this definition will be asked for the 2 marks or 3 marks. So it is given by theta b, that is Brewster angle, the angle at which no reflection is occur in the medium at the origin, so that is called as a Brewster angle. So theta b is equal to sin theta b divided by permittivity of first medium divided by permittivity of first medium plus permittivity of second medium. So this is an equation will be give the Brewster angle. If the first medium is free space equation, then relative permittivity of second medium then is equal to sin theta b under root relative permittivity of minus 1 divided by relative permittivity square minus 1. So this is an equation when the first medium is free space and second medium is relative to the relative permittivity, that is can be given. Then we go to the again reflection from the perfect conductor. Since electromagnetic energy cannot be passed through a perfect conductor in plane wave of incident, and conductor has all its energy will be reflected. So that time the perfect conductor will be used for the shielding purpose. The electrical field polarization in plane of incident for that boundary condition will be, means that theta is equal to theta r. So incident angle is equal to reflected angle. So incident electromagnetic energy is equal to reflected electromagnetic energy. This is for the in parallel position. So in the electrical field in the plane of incidence, and second the E field is horizontally polarized through the boundary conditions, that time we give the incident angle is equal to reflected angle. So incident energy is equal to reflected energy minus reflected energy. So electrical field is normal to the plane. So this is the two components when the conductor is perfect. Okay, so perfect conductor, the Fresnel reflection coefficient for the parallel position, that is one. And when the reflection coefficient we consider in perpendicular, means normal to the incident, that is minus 1. So we can give the reflection coefficients in terms of perfect conductor. That time this perfect conductor will be act as a shielding purpose, so there is a totally reflection will be take place. Then we go to the ground reflection model, two ray model. So in three phase propagation there is a no obstacle present between the transmitter and receiver antenna, so direct traveling of energy from transmitting antenna to receiver antenna. So the base station mobile is rarely only physical path is existent, hence free propagation model is most cases inaccurate. when we use in a basically is an idealistic model. So we can use the two ray model, that is ground reflection model, in base of geometrical optics. So it consists of both direct path and ground reflected propagation path between the transmitter and receiver. This was found the reasonably accurate for predicting a large scale signal strength over a distance of several kilometers for a mobile radio system using a tall tower height 50 meters, and the also it consider the line of sight microcell channel in urban areas. So in this model, basically we have studied when the traveling of a electromagnetic wave from transmitter from base station to the mobile station, that is a two way. First one is a line of sight, and second one is a in the form of wave traveling from ground to that mobile station, that is reflected wave. So let us see. So ground reflection model, that good for all the system use all tower height above over 50 meter height, and good line of sight for the microcell system in urban environment. So whenever in most urban areas, the line of direct transmission of electromagnetic wave from transmitter receiver is not possible. So we can define in two ways the maximum separation distance, that is theta incident angle, and this. So transmission of this electromagnetic wave, that is first phase, that is electromagnetic line of sight, and second one, it is a incident electromagnetic wave is equal to reflected. So total energy which is received to the receiver, that is electromagnetic energy from the line of sight and plus electromagnetic energy from the reflected. So this is the total energy which is received. And to define the model, how much amount of energy will be received, that we consider by using this 2GRM model. So E total is the electrical field result from combination of direct line of sight and ground reflected path. So this is a we can define in terms of the vector component. So E0 with the reference point from the D0. So total this energy will be defined ED0 into divided by D, where D0 is a reflected point where the energy is maximum. So cos omega c T minus D minus C. So E0 into D, which is the amplitude of electrical field, which is the distance D, and omega c is the angular frequency. So FC is a your carrier frequency of the signal. We notice the different distance have a different phase because normal is similar to. So this is a vector component. So total energy can be represented in vector component. For direct path, D is equal to D dash, and reflected path we can define the distance D double dash. So total distance, the total energy in the form of electrical component we can define from this equation. So for the large distance between transmitter and receiver, the incident angle goes to zero, and angle of incident ground reflected wave is equal to, for that purpose the reflection coefficient is minus 1. And we also define the phase difference can occur depending upon the phase difference between the direct line of sight and reflected field. So phase difference, that is denoted by delta theta, the path difference, that is delta. So delta theta is a phase difference and delta is a path difference. So D double dash, so which is from we can consider, so the path difference from this to this, that is delta double dash, and the path difference from line of sight to the transmitter, that is D dash. So to analyze, to calculate the path difference as well as the phase difference, and here we can use the method images below to calculate the path difference. D double dash is equal to D minus. So we can calculate HR into ST into HR, where ST is the height of the transmitting antenna of a base station. Mostly it is considered from the which is when the it is mounted on a building, the height will be calculated from the base of the along with the building height, and HR is the height of the your receiving antenna or above your mobile station. It will be present on a in a victim, or we can say the user on the bus traveling or in a car. So that is this. So we can calculate by using this image methods. So this is a geometric way will be calculated. So we can get the part difference which is to be calculated here by two triangles. So under root ST plus HR whole square plus D square minus HT minus HR D square into D square. So we can calculate the part difference by using this is a very important equation. By using Taylor's series equations, we can calculate 2ST into 2HR divided by T. So this is an actual part difference which is to be calculated. Now the phase difference on time delay, that is to be calculated 2 delta into T, where delta is a part difference divided by T, and lambda is nothing but the wavelength, so which is to be calculated omega c divided by c, where omega c is the angular frequency and c is the velocity of light, and time delay, that is this can be calculated delta, that is part difference divided by light of the velocity of light, so delta theta divided by 2 pi fc, where fc is the angular frequency of a electromagnetic waves. So d is a large, then the difference between become negligible, and amplitude of line of sight and r virtually identical, and difference only in phase. So e zero is equal to, so we can cancel it. This is totally when the d is a large between transmitter and receiver. So we can give the time delay. So time delay is calculated. So time is nothing but the this is for the reflected part distance divided by velocity of light. So we can define the total energy which is received at a receiver. So E total is equal to, in terms of the time delay, E0 into D0 divided by D cos omega C D double minus D into C divided by minus ED0 cos theta 0. So we can calculate. So delta theta is a phase difference. Okay. So we can calculate this is the total energy of received in terms of the component. Again, we draw the referring to the phasor diagram for this. So we can calculate the total energy by using separated distance d between transmitter and receiver. So under root E0 into D0 divided by T cos square phase difference divided by minus 1 bracket whole square plus E0 D0 divided by D sin square phase difference, where E0 is your reference electromagnetic energy. Okay, reference electromagnetic energy which is to be calculated. So we can calculate these terms. Again, we calculate the total energy in terms of the reference energy divided by reference point divided by T. The reference point where the maximum energy will be observed, or maximum electric energy will be received. So if it is well 2 minus 2 cos phase difference, so we can write again in terms of the second formula. So we can put this equations, and we get the 2 into E0 D0 divided by D sin theta delta, where the phase difference is divided by 2. As the electrical is a function of sine decay, oscillatory function with the local maximum of 6 dB greater than the phase-less equation. So this is an example. We can calculate the D0 is 100 meter, which is a reference point, and electromagnetic energy of reference value is 1, and carrier frequency is 1 GHz. The antenna, transmit antenna is 50 meter, and receiving antenna height is 155 at T is equal to 0. So we can calculate this is the graphical electromagnetic field energy in distance in terms of meters. So note that the magnitude respect to reference point E0 is equal to 1 and D0. So this is an equation we can calculate. So we can get, this is the final equation, the received power in terms of electromagnetic or power, that is equal to transmitted power gain of the transmitted antenna, gain of the receiving antenna, height of the receiving antenna, transmitting antenna, height of the receiving antenna square divided by d raised to power 4, where d is the separation distance between transmitting antenna receiving antenna. So two ray path models give the path loss in terms of the dB. So this is the formula: 40 log d minus square bracket 10 log gain of the transmitting antenna plus 10 into log gain of the receiving antenna plus 20 log to the height of the transmitting antenna plus 20 log to the height of the your receiving antenna. So now d square, instead of we write the d square for the phase propagation, so we can write receive power of our is directly proportional to the inversely proportional to the distance between power of the distance power 4, that is 1. So this is, we can write, this is the in terms of the reference point voltage or reference point distance to the actual distance. So we can define it also terms of. So in this lecture we have defined basically two ray model, which is basically used in urban cities, how much amount of energy will be received when transmitting antenna and receiving antenna when the electromagnetic wave travels from line of sight and reflected wave from the ground. And remember, the surface of the earth is a dielectric medium. Okay, so this can be very helpful to calculate the deterministic model. So without a deterministic model, we cannot be consider the how much of an energy is considered, and this is very useful while dealing with the statistical model and to consider the how much of an energy is required. So we can stop here. Thank you.